Prime Minister, Ministers, ladies and gentlemen, let me start by expressing my thanks to our hosts, Prime Minister Anna Bernadić and the Deputy Prime Minister and good friend Nebojša Stefanović. It is a very important event and it is very timely. We all know that cybersecurity is a pressing issue of concern for citizens, governments, economies and businesses, and internet companies across the world. It is really an urgent issue for our democracies, our institutions, our elections, the security of our societies. Digital and online security is intertwined with our physical security and integrity. So, as I said before, today's event is incredibly timely. As the world becomes ever more connected and digitized, pursuing a coherent and operational policy on protecting cyberspace is essential. The online world gives us incredible opportunities to connect, exchange, and learn. But cyber means can be unfortunately also be used for financial gain or for political motives by terrorists, criminals, and state actors. Cybercrimes are easy to perpetrate and can be devastating and difficult to trace or attribute. The latest Internet Organized Crime Threat Assessment report by Europol offers us some stark findings. Europol tells us that the dark net remains a significant area of concern. Europol also tells us about the convergence between cybercrime and terrorism. On top of that, with recent ransomware attacks, a dramatic rise in cyber criminal activity, and the diversification of cyber security incidents, we proposed last year a wide-ranging set of measures to build strong cyber security in the European Union. Terrorists, for example, can abuse the Internet to prepare and facilitate their actions and to disseminate their propaganda. In this context, last week, we proposed a new legislation to ensure that terrorist online content is effectively taken down as quickly as possible, also that online platforms take measures that their services cannot be misused, and finally, that removed content is not re-uploaded elsewhere. Our cooperation with internet companies is crucial, and our voluntary work through the EU Internet Forum over the past 3 years has brought very clear results. It was an initiative I took 3 years ago to set up the so-called Internet Forum that now is upgraded to a global Internet Forum, and I would like once again to commend the contribution and the commitment of the major internet platforms in order to fight terrorist material online. We must continue this partnership and our joint fight against those who try to abuse the great freedoms of internet. I'm really happy that some representatives of these internet companies are also here today. On top of fighting terrorism online, we have also proposed a set of concrete measures to safeguard the order and system of elections in Europe. This includes greater transparency in online political advertisements, and the possibility to impose sanctions for the illegal use of personal data in order to deliberately influence the outcome of the European elections. The objective of our proposals is to address potential threats to elections and thereby strengthen the resilience of the Union's democratic systems. We want to bolster Europe's democratic resilience and make sure that the offline rules created on transparency and to protect the electoral process from any interference also apply online. Together with member states, we should also complete the joint work on the blueprint for cooperation in the event of large-scale cross-border cybersecurity incidents. Moreover, the new measures we propose to combat fraud and the counterfeiting of non-cash means of payment will give a more effective law enforcement response, focusing on detection, traceability, and the prosecution of cybercriminals. This year, we proposed also the creation of the European Cybersecurity Competence Center to invest in stronger and pioneering cybersecurity capacity in the European Union. The Competence Center will help the European Union retain and develop the cybersecurity technological and industrial capacities which are necessary to secure the digital single market. Effective international cooperation is a must if we want to tackle these global threats which do not stop at geographical borders. Effective detection, traceability, investigation, and prosecution are quintessential in our fight against any form of cybercrime. We will only begin to turn the tide on cyber attacks when we increase the chances of criminals getting caught and punished and sanctioned for committing them. We are committed to support and promote the Budapest Convention, the first international treaty seeking to address internet and computer crime, as it is a valid model for an effective standard of cyber legislation and concerted global action against cybercrime. Serbia, for example, together with other partners in the Balkan region, is participating in a joint project of the European Union and the Council of Europe, which strengthens the authorities' capacity to fight cybercrime. We need close cooperation and effective information sharing between all stakeholders to tackle cybercriminality. I already mentioned the internet companies, but international and EU agencies such as Europol and ENISA are the key hubs of our operational cooperation on this. Our Operational Agency for Network and Information Security, the so-called ENISA, also present here today, will get soon a stronger mandate, more resources, and a stronger operational role to support our member states in dealing with cyber threats. It will be somehow the nerve center of our operational response to large-scale cyber incidents at all levels. Dear ministers, Prime Minister, almost 100 years after the end of the First World War, we are no longer fighting in trenches. Instead, we will be increasingly fighting threatening ideas, actions, and systems in the virtual world. We have to fight the ones who are threatening our democracies. We will need to remain vigilant and proactive to stay ahead of the game. But most importantly, we will need to continue working together to fight these transnational and cross-border threats. The challenge of promoting global cyber stability is a task that no country and no region can promote alone. Cybersecurity is a responsibility for all of us, from companies and governmental organizations to each and every last citizen using a connected device. Our perspective and approach can therefore only be global for a threat which is borderless. Once again, congratulations to Serbia and to the Minister for having taken this initiative, and thank you all for your attention.